When Jesus and his disciples had finished eating, he asked, "Simon, son of John, do you love me more than the others do?" Simon Peter answered, "Yes, Lord, you know I do." "Then feed my lambs," Jesus said. Jesus asked a second time, "Simon, son of John, do you love me?" Peter answered, "Yes, Lord, you know I love you." "Then take care of my sheep," Jesus told him. Jesus asked a third time, "Simon, son of John, do you love me?" Peter was hurt because Jesus had asked him three times if he loved him. So he told Jesus, "Lord, you know everything. You know I love you." Jesus replied, "Feed my sheep. I tell you for certain, that when you were a young man, you dressed yourself and went wherever you wanted to go. But when you are old, you will hold out your hands, then others will wrap your belt around you and lead you where you don't want to go." Jesus said this to tell how Peter would die and bring honor to God. Then he said to Peter, "Follow me." Peter turned and saw Jesus' favorite disciple following them. He was the same one who had sat next to Jesus at the meal and had asked Jesus, "Lord, who is going to betray you?" When Peter saw that disciple, he asked Jesus, "Lord, what about him?" Jesus answered, "What is it to you if I want him to live until I return? You must follow me." Those words come from John 21, verses 15 to 22. The night before the crucifixion, Peter denied three times that he even knew Jesus. Then, after the resurrection, Jesus asked Peter to declare three times that he loved the Lord. After that, Peter was the first of the apostles to preach publicly the gospel of Jesus Christ. When you repent, you not only stop repeating your sin, but you also start doing the polar opposite of that sin. When you stop hating your neighbor, you start loving him. When you stop stealing, you begin being a blessing to others as you give of your means to help those in need. When your actions bring shame on the name of the Lord, your repentance means that you will give God glory in everything you do. When Peter repented of his denial of Jesus, he began a lifelong walk of declaring his love for the Lord. Saul, who was a murderer, became Paul, the man who brought life to all those he encountered. When you repent of your sins, you will begin to walk in the opposite direction. With Jesus and the Holy Spirit in your heart, your life will go up from the place where you hit bottom. Don't be surprised if the Holy Spirit leads you to minister to those who are caught in the very sin that had captured you. Peter denied the Lord in a very dramatic and memorable way. Peter also glorified the Lord by proclaiming the gospel of Jesus until the day he died. Lord Jesus, show me today how to bring glory to your holy name, even as I repent of my sin. And Lord, may your name be praised now and forever. Amen.